It's our pleasure to invite our next speaker, Professor Rajnikant Mishra. He's a professor in Department of Zoology in Banaras Hindu University, which is one of the premier universities in India. His research work has been extensively involved around the cancer, and has worked on several aspects of cancer biology over the years. He has worked in one of the premier institutions of cancer research, which is MD Anderson Center of Cancer Research in Houston, Texas, for some time, and thereafter he has been in BHU for some time now. Those who are interested in his research can go on to the website of BHU. There's a lot of information there, but for now we quickly move ahead to his talk. I humbly invite Professor Rajnikant to deliver his lecture. Sir, please.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Asutosh and Dr. Monisa, for this wonderful opportunity to share some experience on research methodology with you all. Good afternoon to all of you. I'm going and biological science. Those students who are interested on the discussion, you can take my email ID and you can discuss. So whenever we do research, first the thing happens to be like what we want to work on. Then we should think about why we want to work on it. Then it comes, if that is justified, then how I would work on it. Then it comes research methodology. Several speakers have talked about like what could be the research methodology. I will tell you about in brief some facts. Like you might have seen some traditional physicians who used to hold your hand and tell you all about your diseases. Ayurvedic medicine practitioners. So that is also a methodology to detect, to know about your physiology. That is based on experience, how they do that. Some like, you might have heard about that some fortune readers, they look on your palm and then they tell about your future. That is also a type of methodology. Then if you might have seen like some students or this is written AGTC, AGTC. So if you are a person who knows English alphabet, then you will say that this is something wrong. Certainly for them it is wrong. But if we write, add these two, 5' and 3', then it becomes, it has some meaning. That is, it could be a nucleic acid. But if it is added N and C, then it becomes a protein. So this is also a type of representation. What is your observation and how you can do that? So there are several methods, and this could be the views of any research scholar or those who are wanting to do research, that yes, how, what could be a gene, what could be a genome, what could be different. So this is, there are certain way to learn about it, but computational methods are reasonably there with accuracy, which can be used to do this in a short period of time, for which we can do this wet lab experiment. So what I try to tell you about, like, it depends upon what you want, why you want, and how we will do this in your research career. Depending upon same way, like if it is a DNA, what you want. If it is RNA, what you want out of it. If it is a protein, what you want out of it. Similarly, there are different methodology, and this is one of the branch of science that is referred as in silico biology and bioinformatics. So by using certain tools, you can do research related to the database and their interpretation on the research outcome. Similarly, for those who have some experience in computational biology, this NCBI is one of the wonderful resources for you, for the biologist. If your interest is in the protein, then you can go through the ExpressE protein server, that is expert protein analysis server. Similarly, those who are interested in working on the molecular biology, DNA cutter, that one of the NEB cutter is one of the best tools where you can find what are the restriction sites on this gene or the genome. And similarly, there is a tool, NetJob 3.1 server, or latest version, which can tell you, like, if it is a peptide, a polypeptide, then what can be used to cleave the peptides into different fragments which could be useful. Like those who are not having much experience in gene or genome, and if they want to study or they know name of the some gene and they want to have some interest, like, yes, I should work on this gene, what are the literature, then this is one of the server gene card which helps you how to work on gene and what are the available literature, what is unknown about it. Similarly, like nowadays or for last few years, we are not talking about just one system, rather we are talking about systems biology. So if you wish to work on the systems biology, you have a very good resource related to the systems biology, which you can look into the Kyoto Encyclopedia of Genes and Genome. Like those who work on the proteins, their interest could be like how to look into the protein-protein interaction. So there are different servers, online servers, freely available for those researchers or those students. They can use this string to look into the what are the protein of my interest and what could be their interacting partners. They can read and know about this. So overall, what I try to tell you that in a research, the students or any researcher might be having a long-term goal, which is referred as a vision. So what do you want? What is your vision in science? Accordingly, you should have a vision, and that could be a long term or maybe a short term. Depending upon that, you should identify aim or maybe more than one aim. Then you should look about that, depending upon that aim, what are the background available? What are the national level and international level, like people who are working in the nations or outside the nation or internationally, what are the status of this work? And then we look on to the statement of problems and decide hypothesis, define objectives, that what could be the objectives to achieve that goal. Then we look into that, if this is the objective, why I should do that and how I should do that. So rational could be, and if we could identify, then we look into the methodology, and methodology could be again very specific depending upon what is your aim and objective, and there could be alternate methodologies if that has to also be decided, because when you are looking into one methodology, if it fails, then you need to look into the alternate methods, what could be the possibility and how I can look into that. Then if that on the basis of that, then you can get some observations. And that observations could be a only observations of qualitative type or quantitative type. And then that could be turned into be results, and based on that we can discuss our result and come to a conclusion, or that could be an innovation. And then we look into that, whether this work which I have done is deliverable or it has some future perspective. And if I am doing that, if it is deliverable, then what are the cost related to this? So that's this way I try to tell you about that. Yes, if this is research, what could be the research methodologies? Then based on implications, we look into two types, basic and applied. If it is basic, then only the basic work or a data analysis, which could be a theoretical, or if it is a laboratory based, then what is the design and what are the implications? Then it could be either a qualitative or a quantitative. So that data analysis theoretically could be either manually based on the experience or computational analysis, for which I try to give you some idea about those servers which are useful in computational analysis. Or if you want to have some model systems like either human, animals, plants, cell lines, environment, they are major models which are used in research. And then we can define our approaches. That approach could be in silico, that is research methodology, in silico, in vitro, in vivo, or in situ, depending upon what are the convenience and availability around. After doing that, what we get in research and in that methodology, that we get data. Research methodology will lead to the data. And if we are selecting out of that data, then that is referred as targeting data. Or what we do after getting data, we do target of the data. Then we do reprocessing of that using different methods, analysis, short-term analysis, based on our experience, comparison. Then we transform that data either for the statistical significance or different types of tests, which to that whether this data is valuable or not. And after that transformation, we do data mining, analyzing different and using different tools. And what we get as a result or observation, which I tried to tell you, that is a pattern. After doing research, only we get a pattern. And the most important part is, like, if we get pattern, then interpretation of that pattern depends upon what is your experience in science, or there you need help of a collaboration or other persons who are expert or may be expert, or their difference in opinion to tell about that. If this is a pattern, this could be whether a novel or a repetitive, or could be requiring future perspective, and that is the knowledge. So in that research methodology, we get such information, and which are there at different levels, we utilize them. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you,
So thank you, Professor Rajnikant, for this wonderful talk. I would now pass on the proceedings to Monisha ma'am, so that we can begin with the student talks.
Hello.
Yes.
Thank you, Dr. Rajnikant. It was a very lucid way of telling how to go about research. And thanks, Ashutosh.
Thank you all.
Okay.